Good morning, Bobcats. I'm Michael Andrews here, and I'm with
Emma Parry.
And today we have the amazing talk show called The Melting Pot. Now, we have a lot of ingredients on our list, I hear. Can you give us a little rundown of what we're going to be going through today?
Sure. Well, we have a reaction segment. We're going to be watching some really fun TikToks. If you haven't heard of TikTok, it is the latest app on the market, and everyone's buzzing about it. After that, we'll have a special guest, a number one golfer all the way from Australia. And after that, we'll be having a game segment.
Yeah, I'm excited. I hear we have a lot of stuff in store today. So I think we should just get started with the reaction segment. I love TikTok. I'm pretty sure all of our viewers are probably on TikTok as well. And if you've seen these, go ahead and comment down below and let us know what you think of them. All right, let's see.
Hi, I'm Kim Kardashian West, and something you might not know about me is that I'm a really good cook, and I love to cook.
Okay.
So I think that was like Kim Kardashian or something.
Yeah,
like,
it reminds me of the Paper magazine cover that she was on.
With the champagne.
Mm-hmm,
I might recreate that.
Yeah, break the internet.
Break the internet. I don't know. I wish you go to the next one because that was kind of a little bit weird for me.
I want to see if I can handle it.
What is going on?
Okay, so this is a trend where you get a weighted blanket and throw it on your head and like fall backwards, and I've seen that's like a 25-pound blanket. And he just fell down the stairs to the basement and probably broke a lot of his bones.
This may be a dumb question, but what is a weighted blanket?
It's so when you sleep, you feel like you have a companion like sleeping with you, so you sleep a lot better. I have a weighted blanket.
Aww.
But I would never throw it on my head and fall down the stairs because here at GCSU, we preach safe practices and we don't want anyone to get hurt. But if you at home want to try it, then go ahead and send it in to us and we may react on next week's Melting Pot. Do we have any more videos? I'm excited.
Okay, well that was just wild. I mean.
Well, she just ate out of the banana.
In the middle of the banana.
I don't know what the point of that was. We don't have any sound in here, so we don't really know what the music was, but I can imagine it'll be like maybe like a dancing song or something, and they were just eating out of a banana.
I think it's just a cringe video.
I don't know. I do hold the record for eating the fastest banana in 16.58 seconds, though. So
is that a world record, or
no.
Is that just
it's a room?
You
it's
record.
A roommate record. So
a roommate record.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that all the videos we have? Yeah. Oh, ooh. One more.
I touched the wall. I swear I'm not on drugs.
Well, I laughed, but I hope I didn't laugh like him.
I don't know what that was. Our producer, Jackie, you know, curated those videos after hours of searching through the For You page, so.
Thank you, Jackie, for
thank you, Jackie.
That.
Round of applause for you.
Yeah.
We love you.
Some golf claps. Ha-ha.
Good intro to the next
Thanks.
Segment, actually.
I'm hoping one day I'll be able to do stand-up.
Welcome to Georgia Water Sports. With our access to over 400,000 new marine power sports and yard equipment related supplies, we are ready to serve you. We also offer oil changes, water pump replacements, winterizations, and repowering. Come on in and we'll have you back out there in no time.
Started with our interview segment. So today we have number one golfer all the way from Australia who plays on the GCSU varsity team. Can you, Bailey Seifley.
That's right.
Yeah. So welcome.
Thank you.
So tell us what made you come all the way here from Australia to Georgia College.
Pretty much just the golf. So at 14, I decided I want to play collegiate level golf in America, and once I graduated high school, I looked into all my opportunities and just transferred over.
That's awesome. Probably redo that, but okay. What was the hardest adjustment for you to make when you came here?
The summertime in Georgia and Alabama, or in the South as a whole, is very humid, and I couldn't believe how humid it was. We'd go out and practice in the summertime and sweat like crazy, and that was the hardest thing for me, because it's coming from such a dry heat. It's such a hard change.
That's true, and I guess the change of the seasons, they're opposite.
That's right. So summertime over back home in Australia right now.
What are some of the biggest differences that you find from home to here?
Driving on the right-hand side of the road, that's a huge one. I've had some close calls.
Okay. Well, we're glad that you're safe. What are some misconceptions that Americans have about Australia?
Generally, most people think that Australia is entirely an outback, but it's not. Like, everyone lives on the outskirts of Australia, so it's very much city and coastal towns. Whereas you go inland and you find the deserts and the outback and all that treacherous stuff.
Okay. If you could golf with anyone ever, who would it be and why?
Tiger Woods, all-time greatest. He's my hero from the get-go. Yeah, absolutely.
And what's the wildest thing you've seen happen on a golf course?
The wildest thing would be one of my mates got hit in the mouth with a golf ball from the other side of the fairway and kind of mangled him up. But the most interesting thing would be kangaroos fighting. So
really?
Yeah, pretty much every time I go out there, I see kangaroos going at it all the time.
They fight each other?
Right. Yeah, they box just like they're seen on Kangaroo Jack and all those kind of movies.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And is your friend okay now?
Yeah, he's great. Yeah. Perfectly fine.
Awesome. Well, thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me.
Iron Fork Cafe, located in downtown Eatonton and open 6 days a week, is the perfect place for your family to enjoy every meal. So here's to bringing our family's delicious recipes passed down through the generations while always served with a side of Southern hospitality. There's no one who does it better than our team. When it comes to private events and catering, we provide the best. With the unique blend of Southern charm and genuine hospitality, we treat all of our customers like our family. Southern, comfortable, delicious.
We're going to go ahead and get started on our next segment. It's a game segment. So what Michael and I are going to do is close our eyes, and we're going to see if we can guess what the items in the box are.
Yeah, so I've seen this game played many times with live animals and various different foods. We had our producer, Austin, curate this box. So we're gonna have another, bring it out here.
So we're just gonna close our eyes now.
Well, we don't have to close them yet.
No?
The box isn't even here yet.
Okay.
Oh, I'm gonna close my eyes. Okay, yeah, we do have to close our eyes. He's actually gonna show the item to the audience. And then we're gonna let us know when we can look. I'm a little bit nervous. Okay, I hear the sound of the box closing. We good to look? Oh, I didn't look. I didn't see it. I swear I didn't see it.
My eyes are so close.
We have 5 items. First of 3 wins.
Okay.
You ready? You don't have to close your eyes. The box is closed.
Oh, okay.
Face mask that you wear when you're painting. Booyah. Point one to me. Next item, please. I don't know how to actually put these things on.
No. That one has to go over too. Are we?
We have our next item. You ready?
Mm-hmm. It's a mic.
Is it?
Yeah.
I didn't even get to feel it. This is unfair.
Okay.
This is unfair. I didn't even get to feel the item in my defense. 1-1. Okay, close your eyes. I think she cheated, honestly. Can we get a cheater check in here? Anyone?
I just felt the mic part.
We have our ref, Chris Kaufman, in the audience, so.
Thank you, Chris, for writing this script.
Are we ready to peep?
Yes.
Eyes closed?
Yes.
Are you going?
Where?
Oh, I found it. Okay.
Okay, let me feel.
Like a piece of paper?
Okay, well.
You go then.
I'm trying to feel it, but you're
it's a little
it.
Far away from me, too. My arms
I'm gonna
are short.
Guess. Oh, well, my eyes are open. Okay, we'll guess on three. I don't really know what this is. You feel it, and then we'll guess.
Is it masking tape?
Is it a dollar bill?
No.
It's not masking tape either?
I don't know what it
is. Is it a folded up sheet of paper?
Is it like wax paper? Should we just pull it out?
No.
No? Okay.
Hold on, can I unfold it? Can we get a, is it unfoldable?
Yeah, I think we should get it.
A coin roller. How do we not get this?
I don't know. It's just, I don't really think I've ever felt what a coin roller feels like before.
I remember when I was
without
a kid,
coins in it.
I used to roll coins all the time in my free time. We should have got this. All right, well, 1-1 still.
The only thing that I remember about coin rollers is when my grandma would bring them home from the bank.
Hello?
To put the quarters in the little
I remember that.
Books.
I love saving coins. I love being financially responsible.
Yeah. There would be like the state map.
Yeah, and you fill up the quarters. You ready to look?
Mm-hmm.
Eyes closed.
Oh, okay. Nope.
Oh, no, we're not ready. I didn't see it, I promise. Sorry. Tough to hear in here with the live audience being so loud. All right, let's go.
He should be done now.
Oh, he is done.
What is that?
Oh, eyes closed. I can't even see you. I'd have to have my eyes closed. You literally can't see in here.
Yeah, what the heck is that?
I'm gonna guess. I have my guess.
Well then guess. What is it?
I'm gonna guess a dog chew toy. That's my guess.
Is
I say you guess and whoever's closest we give it to.
It feels like a stuffed animal of some kind. Like a Happy Meal toy.
Should we just look?
Yeah, let's look. What?
And I'm gonna be honest with y'all, I do not know what this is.
I have no idea what that is.
Okay. Oh, yeah, it's a
cat toy.
I was closest with dog toy.
Yeah, you can have that.
It kind of smells like cats.
Why would you smell it? That doesn't make any sense.
I don't know what they do with this thing, but it definitely does not smell good.
Okay.
All right, I have two items.
We
have one more? Okay. We're out? Well, judging by the looks of things,
I think
I have two items.
We have our winner.
I'm the winner. Thank you.
Welcome to the Soho Lofts, the only luxury suites available in downtown Milledgeville. You stay at the Soho Loft, you're located right in the heart of downtown Milledgeville. It's literally right outside your doorstep. Each suite comes with a fully equipped kitchen, private bathroom, king-size bed, and plush Egyptian cotton robes. Visit our website or call us today to discover more about your future travel destination.
To wrap things up, we've really enjoyed having our guest and playing this game together. And thanks for joining us on The Melting Pot. We'll be back soon.
Yeah, we'll be back next week. We have a great meal with some amazing ingredients, AKA some more fun segments. We want to thank our producer, Angela Crisco, all of our camera people, live studio audience, and everyone. So,
Peace out, you guys.
Peace.